Hello, my name is Carlos. It is now the middle of December in Homestead, Florida. I'm in my grove. We've been changing canopies or varieties in some of my trees. But I noticed that the way it's normally done in South Florida, the trees decapitated, allowed to come back, and then you graft on the water shoots. That is fine for some trees, but for other trees, it is a very traumatic event. Now I am here in December. Some of the trees that we did that to were cut in August. Some, as I will show you, have come back very well. Others have not come back very well, and they are not ready for grafting now in December. So I am trying to explore other avenues. So I did some research on the internet, and I found two old articles, which I will post if I ever get to post this video, that talk about cutting the tree, doing bark graft at the time, and doing cleft grafting. Both systems we're going to try to explore. We have chosen a couple of trees to practice and to test it. Like this tree behind me right now, it has broken up into 1, 2, 3, 4 branches of nice, not too big, not too small, to be able to for us to test the bark grafting. I'll let you know, I've never done this before. It is totally an experiment based on an article that's probably 50 years old. But I think it's worth a try because there are some varieties of trees, like this one here, Dupuis, that don't do well when they get cut in the middle of the summer. So I will show you now some trees that were cut in August and are not doing well at all. As you can see, this tree, it's August, September, October, November, and December, has been cut 5 months ago, and this is all you see here, not much. On the other hand, if we come to this tree here, you see that it's ready to be grafted on the water shoots as we normally do in Florida. This is acceptable to some extent because you can put at least one good graft in here. This one's not too good. I'm afraid I'm gonna miss on a lot of trees on this row. See, I don't think this will support anything. So these type of trees, plus this fungal growth that takes place, I don't think it helps at all. So we're gonna explore other ways of doing this. We now are going to cut the trees at a suitable space so we could begin our bark process, our bark grafting process. First of all, we're going to use this knife that I thought I bought, that I thought I could use it for shaving, but it was not for shaving. It came out great for this. We're going to nice and juicy. We're going to open now the bark. Very nice and juicy. We're going to open up the bark a bit. Actually, I need something longer. Okay, it's already opened up. It's nice and we already picked our scion wood and it's covered with parafilm. There we go, perfect, perfect, perfect. We push it in, there. There's one. Already done, very easy. We're gonna go straight to the other one. And we're gonna do it probably here. We're gonna do it here. I love this knife, $6 knife. I bought it by accident. I thought I could use it to chafe, but it's made for this.
Crazy. You need something a little bit longer than this, but what is all I have? Okay. Okay. Actually, this is very fast. You see how nice the buds are on this? We're just gonna leave one like this lined up on the outside, because sometimes these die and then this start growing. There we go. There, ooh, perfect. See?
And the other cut on the other side.
The layers, and we're gonna put it in here. Hold this for me, please. There.
Man, it came up beautiful. Looks beautiful there.
There, okay, now we're going to check. Most of the time today, I'm lucky I have help. My friends from Maya West are here. But sometimes I have to do this by myself. And with my arthritic hands, I just don't have the energy to. I just bought this gizmo. There we go, it's tightening. Actually, very tightening, very nice. Oh, yeah, perfect. Tight. Tight. Then with the squeeze of the other trigger, pow, there you go. This is very nice and tight. Let me get the camera off. This is how it looks. We need to now fill these holes with 3-1. This tight doing a great job. Now we're gonna take 3-1 and make sure we fill these holes in the bark. And on here. And once you do this, you have to come back in 2 or 3 days because it will crack. Then apply it again to be extra safe. No air coming. Once we finish grafting all the trunks, we cover them with brown paper bags that have been varnished with shellac, or sometimes I could use Thompson water sealers. We'll come back and check them in about 3 weeks, see if any of them took. Okay. Once we... Well, I'm not sure whether I should let this parafilm decay. But what I'm always afraid is that it's going to start collecting water in the wrong spots, and it could be more of a problem. So I'm just going to roll it back and tighten it here, and we'll keep watching. I don't think that was in there when I grafted last week, so this may be one of those grafts that it just hits it right off and the budwood keeps growing without delay. So we'll see. We're going to basically repeat what we've done before, which seemed to have worked very well. Just pick a good spot here. This spot looks good. Make a cut with this knife. Okay, lifting. Thank you.
there. Maybe a little bit more.
Try to push it with some pressure. Okay, this one is in. We're gonna do another one. This part did not lift, but I think it's okay. We're gonna pick this, the one that's a little greener, darker, I mean. See if we could do the inside here. Oh. Looks good, I think. Okay. I'm gonna put this material, smush it to seal this, especially in the wounded part of the bark. Right through the middle. And then cut it like that. See? And it's just like a different type of cut. I think it's more, it has more support.